Amidst a major shift in global power dynamics, China is once again moving forward with a military project that has the world breathless. It's not hypersonic missiles, nor a sixth-generation fighter jet, but a massive nuclear aircraft carrier that is now the focus of defense analysts' attention. Steel mills at the Dalian shipyard hum nonstop, assembling a naval colossus that is touted as reshaping the Indo-Pacific. The vessel is designated the Type 004, and if completed as predicted, the world will witness the birth of the largest and most advanced aircraft carrier ever built by a non-Western nation. A strategic move that directly challenges the dominance of the United States. The Type 004 is designed as a supercarrier with a displacement of between 110,000 and 120,000 tons, making it larger than the USS Gerald R. Ford, the US Navy's most modern and largest aircraft carrier, which weighs around 100,000 tons. This size is not simply a symbol of prestige, but rather a representation of China's ambition to have a warship that can rival and even surpass what the US has built for decades. At approximately 340 meters long, the Type 004 is also longer than the Fujian and even slightly longer than the Gerald R. Ford. These large dimensions provide ample space for high-tech aviation facilities. A larger aircraft hangar, two high-capacity aircraft elevators, and a larger logistics area will make this ship a high-capacity naval air operations center. The result of this massive design is the ability to carry 90 to 100 fighter aircraft, a number never before achieved by any Chinese aircraft carrier. This capacity places the Type 004 in the true supercarrier category, on par with US aircraft carriers, and far ahead of the Shandong and Liaoning carriers, which still use ski jump decks with limited air capacity. One of the Type 4's greatest advantages is its integration of EMALS, Electromagnetic Aircraft Launch System, an electromagnetic launch system unique to the United States Ford-class aircraft carriers. This technology allows aircraft to be launched faster, smoother, and more efficiently than traditional steam catapults, while also providing flexibility for the deployment of a wide variety of aircraft, including future combat drones. The Type 004 is also expected to carry a next-generation phased array radar, capable of tracking stealth fighters, hypersonic missiles, and even small, high-speed drones. Analysts even believe this radar has the potential to rival the Aegis system, making it one of the world's best-equipped ships with situational awareness. With these capabilities, the Type 004 aircraft carrier will not only be an aviation platform but also an electronic warfare hub, capable of coordinating large-scale maritime operations. The artificial intelligence, AI-based command and control system expected to be installed on the ship will transform the Type 004 into the operational brain of the People's Liberation Army Navy Plan Combat Fleet. The core of the Type 4's superiority lies in its nuclear reactor, which is its primary power source. With nuclear propulsion, the vessel can operate for extremely long periods without refueling, enabling long-distance voyages around the world without the logistical constraints that are typically a weakness of conventional aircraft carriers. China is basing this technology on its experience developing the Type 093 and the next-generation Type 095 nuclear submarines. This technology transfer gives Beijing a high degree of confidence in implementing a nuclear-powered reactor on a giant vessel like the Type 4, a technological leap not even Russia or the UK have achieved. If the combination of the nuclear reactor and EMALS works as planned, the Type 004 will have operational capabilities that are not only efficient but also sustainable. It will essentially become a global power projection platform capable of sailing without borders, heralding a new era of Chinese maritime power. Recent satellite imagery dating back to 2025 shows that construction of the Type 004 is progressing aggressively at the Dalian shipyard. Giant hull and main deck modules can be seen being assembled in dry dock, indicating that construction has entered the core phase. The presence of elongated structures above the deck supports the suspicion of an EMALS system. Significant changes are also visible in the industrial area surrounding the shipyard, including the installation of large-capacity cranes and the strengthening of dry dock facilities. This indicates that China is preparing its shipyard to assemble a ship with true supercarrier dimensions. Furthermore, the land-based aircraft carrier test facility in Wuhan is also undergoing major renovations. This activity is believed to be related to the development of the electromagnetic catapult system and aircraft recovery mechanism that will be used on the Type 004 with these two major test centers. China demonstrates a high level of commitment to completing its first nuclear supercarrier project. The arrival of the Type 004 will drastically change the power dynamics in the Indo-Pacific. Until now, the United States' maritime dominance in the region has been supported by nuclear-powered aircraft carriers capable of unrestricted operations. However, with the advent of the Type 004, America now faces a competitor that offers nearly equal, and in some respects even superior, capabilities. With its large air wings, advanced sensors, and unlimited cruising range, the Type 004 provides China with a platform to conduct power projection missions beyond East Asia. This means China can be more active in international operations, supporting its interests in Africa, the Middle East, and even the Indian Ocean. If the Type 004 becomes operational in the mid-2030s, the Indo-Pacific region has the potential to become the epicenter of a confrontation between two superpowers, China and the United States, along with the NATO alliance. Competition that has traditionally been fought in the air and on land will now shift deeper into the oceans, making the Type 004 a key symbol of China's maritime rise. The Type 004 is more than just an ambitious project. It's a powerful signal that China has entered the world-class aircraft carrier competition with full confidence. If all goes according to plan, the world will witness the birth of a new maritime power with the potential to challenge the United States' dominance of the oceans. And when that happens, the Indo-Pacific power landscape will never be the same again.